Soft brown, Lamb Hicks, Charlie, and the Waterline.
And we'll be going in this long
in
channel
here.
Is
a soft brown van
and a
mixture of things in the mid channel that some places is quite bare. Macrocystis, soft brown, looks like mostly one species of red.
This is all a veneer of sort of boulder cobble-sized sediment, sort of slaty material, a little finer up at the high water line.
Mucus is just glowing.
And it gets finer here, wetlands started to pick those up. And it's sort of
here.
A pebble cobble-sized material, upper intertidal, and then the sand flat in the lower portion of the intertidal. And
so
we've got wetlands off to the margins here at the head of the inlet. That's good. If we could loop around and get the other one over there too, shoot back here. Beautiful little wetland of meanders and things up at the upper intertidal. Again, sort of pools in the upper intertidal.
Feature of the upper intertidal.
Portions
pools.
Of all of these streams.
Wow, this is an estuary. She has wetland grasses well up the narrow stream bound.
A little margin of wetland here, just 2 or 3 meters in width, and then you're into the sand flat.
Ova and eelgrass up on the flats.
Size material.
Mucus is confined to the beach face.
Here we're picking up our wave exposures. We come out much coarser material in the upper portion of the intertidal. Oh, beautiful eelgrass, eh?
Yeah.
Wow.
Near shore, Nereocystis, urchins.
And a wide rock platform, a sort of slaty material. Weathers into a discontinuous
area at the waterline.
Boulder cobble-sized slater plates.
Mid intertidal.
Top of the rock platform.
Doesn't look very lush or diverse. Upper intertidal is the difficult mucus. Patchy mucus throughout lots of.
There's a big quartz dike.
Barnacles.
Cutting across the bedrock. I've seen a few of those big quartz veins cutting through the bedrock.
31.
Sand beach
Laminaria
face up high,
Cicelli,
going right up
the
into
water
the tree line. 5 meters in width, medium to coarse sand.
Coral and
then discontinuous cover of pebble cobble over the rock
there
platform.
Upwards, it's hard to say. It's hard to characterize.
Again, a Finlayson beach race, 5 meters wide, a high tide tidal pool with some sand.
It actually has a bare look to it, and it is bare, just below the barnacle band. That rock looked just like a seal's head. And
here we've got a large sand flat. Beach face, 5 meters in width, medium sand material.
Lots of mucus across the flats. A couple things that look like erratics. A few streaks of surf rust.
Probably sand material.
Alba greenery.
Beach face, pebble sand material.
And
here it looks like we've changed our bedrock type a bit into a sandstone. Lots of sea caves up along the high water line there. Lots
of
them.
Ground
and
water
and probably some in the super tidal as well. Wide rock platforms. Pebbly sand beach face, 5 meters in width. Discontinuous boulder cobble veneer in the mid intertidal. Here we've got sandblasts in the lower portion of the intertidal. And we've got sand flats right across there, right from the high water line down low. About 5 meters in width, beach face, pebbly sand. just coming up to the place where we started here. Okay. Yeah. Starting right at the point where we left off from our last survey, and a little
huge
bit of a beach
berm
out here, 5 meters wide, boulder cobble over the rock platform, and you can see the whole area, which would have been all mid material for sure, on the point here. Do you know where the fort actually was? Do they know where that was?
Photo 34.
It sure looks like that. All of those houses.